My name is Kwame Alexander. What am I known for? I got a lot of different sort of titles. Poet, author, educator. I want to change the world one word at a time. This is book number 15. I was fortunate enough that it won the Coretta Scott King Honor and the Newbery Medal. The Newbery Medal is like the Oscar Awards for the best children's book. And it changed my life. It made sure that my books would have an entree into the hands of students all around the country, all around the world. Because of this book, like, I've traveled to Italy and Ghana and Brazil and Shanghai and Singapore. And what I've learned is that the words allow us to feel more connected with each other. The Crossover is a novel in verse, meaning it's a story with a beginning, a middle, and an end, and it's told through poems. I believe in the power of poetry. I love all this white space for the reader. I love how you can talk about such heavy things in so few words. The idea for The Crossover came because someone pitched me the story. They said, Kwame, you should do a book about basketball. There should be a boy as the main character. You should tell it in verse. And I was like, okay, great idea. And as it turns out, the publisher that pitched me this idea ended up not liking it. You know, and I thought, I was like, really? After all this? Like, I spent like a year and a half, 2 years working on it. And she just didn't like it. And then I got another agent. And over the next 6 months, we got about 17 or 18 rejections. And it was the same thing. It's poetry. Nobody buys poetry. It's basketball with a boy. Girls aren't gonna read it. Boys don't read books. Your book's never gonna sell. My agent believed and we persevered and eventually we got an offer. When it got published, it was the best decision I ever made. I tell that story a lot to students because it's really about the power of dribble, fake, shoot, miss. Dribble, fake, shoot, miss. Dribble, fake, shoot, miss. Dribble, fake, shoot, swish. You gotta keep taking the shots. This is The Undefeated. This is a love letter to America, to Black America. This truly is, if you think about it, this is the voice of America. This is for the underdogs and the uncertain, the unspoken but no longer untitled. The beauty of poetry is, number one, it's the rhythm. It can be rhyme, it doesn't have to be. It's the repetition. It's comparing things that are unlike. It's the white space. Because as much as poetry is about the words that are there, it's also about the words that aren't there. I think most importantly, poetry is about showing, not telling. How do I paint a picture for you through words? And that's what I tried to do with this, with The Undefeated. This is for the unbelievable, the we real cool ones. This is for the unbending, the black as the night is beautiful ones. We Real Cool is an ode to a poem written by Gwendolyn Brooks. Black as the night is beautiful is an ode to a line from a Langston Hughes poem. I think the way we learn how to write, how to read, how to speak, how to listen, is by reading other people. It's by reading and learning what works and what doesn't. Reading books, in particular poetry, is one of the most surefire ways of getting a grasp of language and its power. This is for the undefeated. This is for the undefeated. This is for you, and you, and you, and you. This is for us.